So in the first part of the video, we learned how to convert mass into moles, moles into number, number into moles, moles into mass, moles into volume of gas at STP, volume of gas at STP to moles. Keeping in mind volume of gas at STP only, we have to divide by 22.4 liter or multiply by 22.4 liter. We should never use that formula, never use that logic for liquid or a gas without STP condition. Now, in this segment of the video, I'm going to tell you a very important class of question, that is calculating the number of entities and vice versa. So what they will give you? They will give you a sample and they will ask you the number of entities in that sample. Entities means things. Those things can be atoms, electrons, protons, neutrons, maybe nucleons. Nucleons is total neutron plus proton, or maybe charge. So they can give you the sample in three ways. They can give you mass, they can give you number, or they can give you volume of the gas at STP. Also, they can as well give you the moles as well directly for a very straightforward simple question. So to get this kind of a question, firstly make sure that you remember what is the thing you have to know before entering into moles. So let us see how to find number of atoms. Number of atoms in one molecule is also known as atomicity. For example, for water, the atomicity is going to be 3. Why 3? There are 2 hydrogen atoms, 1 oxygen atom, total 3. Let's say for H2SO4, can you find? 4, 1, 5, 6, 7. Similarly, if I take K4FeCN6, the atomicity is going to be 4, 5. Now see, it is whole 6. That means 6 nitrogen and 6 carbon. So 12 plus 5, total 17 will come. I hope you understand this one. 6 nitrogen, 6 carbon, 12, 1, 13 and 4, 17. So this is number of atoms in a molecule, atomicity. How to get number of protons? Easiest one. Number of proton is equals to atomic number. For example, if they ask you for deuterium, now deuterium is an isotope of hydrogen. Deuterium, hydrogen, tritium, all of them have 1 proton inside their nuclei. Then how they differ? They will differ here in number of neutrons, but number of protons are same. In the same way, oxygen has atomic number 8. Understand? Mass is different, atomic number is different. Atomic number of oxygen is 8, nitrogen 7, and that is the number of protons you have. Another example here, if I write Na plus, will he have one extra proton? No. Na plus has one less electron. Number of protons for iron also is the atomic number only. And atomic number of sodium is 11. That means for sodium as well as Na plus, the number of protons are same. That is 11 only. It does not matter you have cation, anion. Number of protons, number of neutrons does not change. How to get number of neutrons here? Very simple. Number of neutron is A minus Z. What is A? A is mass number. What is Z? Z is atomic number. Both these things you have to remember for every atom. For example, if I take oxygen, then for him the mass number is 16. Atomic number is 8, so there are total 8 neutrons. If I take the example here of, let's say, tritium. Tritium has a mass number of 3. Atomic number, as I discussed, is 1. So in total, there are 2 neutrons. Similarly, deuterium has mass number of 2, atomic number of 1, total 1 neutron. How to find number of electrons here? Now, it's a very classic method of finding it. Do Z minus charge. And when you put charge here, make sure you have to put including sign. You have to put the sign also there. If it is plus, put plus. If it is minus, put minus. Let's take this example of Na plus. Let's take one example of we can take O2 minus. Also, we can take an example of N3 minus. So now, in the case of Na plus, atomic number of sodium I discussed already is 11. How much charge on the top? Plus 1. So minus charge. That is minus 1. 10 electrons will come. O2 minus, atomic number of oxygen is 8. you have to remember this atomic number. Don't expect that sir will tell some technique to remember the atomic number also. Make sure to remember the atomic number and mass of the first 20 elements minimum to minimum here. Preferably 30, but at least 20 first you should remember. Now, oxygen minus, charge is minus 2, minus minus plus, so 10 electron. Here nitrogen also, atomic number 7, minus minus 3, again 10 electrons. One more thing you can understand here, they are all isoelectronic, their total electrons are equal. But anyway, that's how you can find the number of atoms in molecule, number of electrons, protons, neutrons. Make sure to make the note of it. It's very, very important thing. You have to be expert in this. Then only mole concept will help you. As I said in the previous video also, sometimes the stoichiometry can be weak, but it is mostly weak because of the previous topics, not the junior intertopic actually. Charge. If you ever get, see, listen very carefully here. This is a very important part here. People mess it up. If you take Al3 plus, N3 minus, Ca2 plus, Na plus. Let us take these examples. Al3 plus has plus 3 charge. Nitrogen has minus 3. Calcium has plus 2. Sodium has plus 1. And this is exactly wrong. Why? Charge is not plus E. It is plus 3. It is plus 3E. It is minus 3E. Plus 2E. Plus 1E. Do not forget E. So what is E? E for elephant, obviously not. E is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. So the charge on Al3 plus is not 3 coulomb. It is 3 into 1.6 into 10 to the minus 19. That is 4.8 into 10 to the minus 19 coulombs. Be very sure with this example also. Number of nucleons, very simple. It's simply equal to the mass number. For example, for oxygen, 16. Nitrogen 14, carbon 12, etc. Many such examples are there. So firstly, you understood how to find the number of entities in one unit of that thing. One unit of the ion, one unit of the molecule, one unit of the sample given to you. You found how to find the number of electron, proton, neutron, charge and atoms. Now steps in the mole concept. Number one, convert sample into moles. In the previous video we learned how to convert any given sample into moles. Step number one. Step number two, find number of asked entity in one unit of sample. In one unit of the molecule, one unit of the atom, one unit of the ion. Whosoever is the asked entity, they ask atom, electron, proton, neutron, charge or nucleon. Whatever they ask you, find the number of that in one entity. That means find this, what I just now trained you to find. You have to find this in the second step. Step number three, you have to apply unitary method. Now those who don't know what is unitary method, don't worry. Maybe you already know it. Maybe you are not familiar with this name. I'll tell you also while solving the question what is unitary method. But anyway, these are the steps we have to follow. So let's quickly jump on to an example. Check if you are able to get through it or not. So here, the first example let us take is find number of neutrons in, let us take 40 gram D2O sample. So, you have to find the number of neutrons in 40 gram D2O sample. So, again, whenever you see the question, firstly understand which type of question they are asking. They are asking you to find the number of neutron, proton, nucleon, charge, electron. In such questions, be very, very sure that this is calculation of entity. You have to just follow the steps. As far as you are reading very well, your heart is at the right place, I am properly preparing for the NEET exam, these steps you will remember. If your steps are clear, answer will 100% come. Standard question it is. So what's the first step? What you should do first? Calculate, convert the sample into moles. So it is mass. Remember why map in the previous video, how to convert mass into moles? By given mass by molar mass. So how to find molar mass of D2O here? So D2O, oxygen mass is 16, hydrogen is 1, deuterium is 2, tritium is 3 mass. So deuterium is 2. So 2 into 2, 4 plus 16, 20 gram per mole is the molar mass. That's the mass of D2O. Practice calculation the molar mass, calculating the molar mass also very well. Now given mass, it's 40. Molar mass, it is 20. So you got 2 moles. Number 1. Number 2, find number of asked entity in 1 unit of sample. Simple. 1 D2O has dash 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 neutrons. So when I asked you to find number of asked entity in 1 unit of sample, what they asked? They asked us to find number of neutrons. So I will find number of neutron in 1 entity of D2O, 1 D2O. As simple as that. Let us see. So deuterium uncle, D2O is there, na? So deuterium uncle has 1 neutron. How do I know? I just calculated in the previous part. I just removed it from here. You can calculate again also. Mass number 2, atomic number 1. Mass number minus atomic number is number of neutron. That is 1 neutron. Oxygen, mass number 16, atomic number 8, 8 neutrons. So in total, D2O will have 2 plus 8 equal to 10 neutrons. I'll write here 10. This part also practice well. Previous video what I asked you to become a master in, practice that with your own hands. See all the same examples also you can see again. You don't have to innovate all the examples, but just remember the mass number and atomic number for God's sake for the first 20 elements minimum. Now 1D2O, 10 neutrons. Now step number 1 done, step number 2 done, step number 3, apply unitary method. Now here it's very simple. If 1D2O has 10 neutron, so 1 has 10, 2 will have 20. How to understand it? Simple. If 1 chocolate is of 10 rupees, what is the cost of 5 chocolate? 50 rupees. Cost of 6 chocolate? 60 rupees. In the same way, if 1D2O has 10 neutron, 2 will have 20, 3 will have 30, 4 will have 40, 5 will have 50, 6 has 60, 7 has 70, 8 has 80, A has 10A. And 2 moles, D2O has 10 into 2 moles neutron, that is 20 moles neutrons. So from where you put 2 moles? Because that was a sample. I converted the sample into moles, and this is what unitary method is known as. So what is unitary method? Knowing the number of entities in 1 unit and then multiplying your desired quantity both sides. So I came to know 1D2O has 10 neutron. I multiplied 2 moles on both sides. So I got 2 moles D2O has how many neutrons? I knew 1D2O has how many neutrons? I multiplied my desired quantity both sides. So I got 2 moles D2O has how many neutrons? 20 moles. If they ask number, simple here, how to convert moles into number? Multiplying with Avogadro number. So it's 120 into 10 to the power 23 neutrons. So this is one part of the question.